Great, thanks, guys. I am here with the Smacktivist. Mac, I know that was a really hard game.
Yeah.
You and I talked before the game about what we expected out of that game, and one of the things that we pointed to was the fact that in Helsinki's last game, they got a lot of jammer penalties, but you said their defense is going to be tough. Was it?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, they had it locked down. I think at first I was able to get around some folks pretty easily, but they like really had my number by the end of the game. Like, you could obviously see I was like struggling against even like their three walls. They have a really strong defensive line, so.
And your idea of struggling is different than my idea of struggling, because you get 141 points in that game. But it was an important game for you. Can you talk a little bit about that?
Yeah, I mean, for us, like, you know, if we had won that game, we would have advanced, obviously. We're not going to now, which is really hard. But also, I mean, it was important for us as a team, honestly, because that was one of the best games we've played, like, in the last 2 or 3 years, absolutely. And we had a really, really trying season, like, interpersonally within our team and just in terms of not having a venue for practices and all kinds of stuff. So that was sort of like, we were like, this is what we've come here for. This is the next step for us. So it's definitely hard to walk away with a loss, but I'm really, really proud of everything we did. So.
Yeah, and this game definitely felt a little bit different in terms of the team dynamic.
Yeah.
I think yesterday it was very much your game, 117 points against Windy City, but this game was different.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, apparently I scored many points, but it wasn't certainly without the help of my team. Like, I think it's very apparent that we were playing a lot more offense, that it was more effective. And in general, I think one of the things we've struggled with all season is really coming out as a team and not as individuals. And this game, particularly at least from the bench and from the track, felt so much more like we were a unit and we weren't, you know, fighting against each other to make something work. So,
speaking of individuals, I really want to apologize to you for any issues that we've had with your pronoun, because it's not just about a pronoun. It's about respect, and it's about inclusion, and it's about being a part of this sport and helping to make it what it is.
You
and I talked in Michigan about how we need to find a place to start the conversation in a meaningful way. What are your thoughts about that?
I have a lot of them. I'll try to keep it brief, but I mean, it's I appreciate the apology, certainly, and it's something that I obviously, when I'm skating, I don't think about it. I'm just playing, you know, but, and then I get, you know, done playing, and on the internet, everyone's like, bah, and I'm like, oh God. Okay. But I think I appreciate when people are willing to correct their mistakes. And I know that oftentimes it's not done with ill intent. But people are quick to say, you know, well, I didn't mean anything about it, and use that as an excuse to not correct their behavior. But I always really appreciate when people are like, yeah, you know what? I did mess up, but I'm going to work hard. And if I keep messing up, I'm sorry, but I'm going to keep working on it. And that's for me what matters. And I think it's really easy for people to say, well, you're playing a woman's sport, so you're a woman, so we're just going to call you she. And I think that's valid, but there's a lot of people that don't fall on the spectrum of man or woman, myself being one of those people. And for me, I consider myself, you know, gender expansive, but I'm still super in touch with, you know, the feminine parts of myself. And this is what feels like home for me. So if I can't feel at home here because people, you know, aren't willing to make a little bit of space for me, I definitely don't feel like I'm going to feel at home at like Wftda or something, because that's just not something that I'm familiar with or something I'm comfortable with. And so, you know, this is where I feel like I belong, but we need to definitely have conversations about making the sport more inclusive. And it's not anything against like people who do identify as women, certainly, but it's also just about, what about the people who maybe don't, but who feel like this is a space for them? How can we keep it a space for them?
And it's not just skaters, it's support staff,
yeah,
it's announcers,
absolutely.
It's everyone
absolutely.
Involved in our
absolutely.
Community. And speaking of a place on a team, I skated with you in Kitchener-Waterloo at an open scrimmage.
That was a while ago.
And I remember being so starstruck. I've been sitting on this hashtag for about a week now, and I think it's going to belong to you. I saw that inside line jump that you attempted, so I'm going to use the hashtag Bapex Jump anytime you are on the track, Mac.
Thank you.
You heard it here first, Bapex Jump, awarded to Mac.
Thank you.
I'm Double H here with the Smacktivist. Thank you so much for talking to me.
Thank you.
This is a great game.
Thanks everyone for watching, and thanks Wftda for being around.
And thank you for being around on WFTDA.TV. We'll be right back after this.